Hi guys, David and David here from payitforward.com and upphone.com, and in this video we're going to explain what to do when your iPhone camera is black.
There are a number of different things that can cause this problem, so let's start with the easiest one, and that's to close and reopen the camera app.
Yeah, it could just be a software crash. So on an iPhone 10 or newer, opening the app switcher, swipe up from the bottom of the screen to the center of the screen, and just swipe that camera app up and off the top of the screen. iPhone 8 and earlier, any iPhone with the home button, double press the home button, app switcher.
Swipe it off the top of the screen.
And then if I reopen it, oh look, my problem is fixed.
Right.
Except I didn't.
But you never had the problem to begin with. So if this problem isn't happening within the camera app, just to say that, we're gonna fix that too.
Yep.
So if it's a camera app problem, that is usually a fix. Next step, restart your iPhone. So to reset an iPhone or restart your iPhone, press and hold the
power button.
Yep,
until slide of power off appears. And these iPhone 10 and newer,
it's a little different.
Side button, either volume button.
Yep.
Press and hold till slide of power off appears. And
right. Don't sound so excited about it, dude.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's restarting your iPhone. Explaining those steps every time it's fun.
Yep.
So you restart your iPhone and the camera is still black. Try wiping off the lens. Maybe there's some gunk or whatever on the screen. Take a microfiber cloth. Really just clean it off.
Yeah, and make sure the case isn't obstructing the
lens. Yeah, this isn't as big of a problem anymore because the cameras kind of jut out, but back on the older iPhones, they were flat. Like we have an iPhone, what is that, a 5C?
Yep.
Use our overhead cam and it's just a flat camera, and if you put your case on upside down.
People would do that all the time.
Yeah.
You're right, the upside down case problem.
Yeah, so upside down case. I tried it on my case and it didn't really work because the camera juts out and it doesn't fit.
Yep.
So your case is on correctly. Are you using an app that requires the camera to give permission to the camera? So like if you sign up for Instagram and you want to post a picture that you just took on your iPhone, you need to give Instagram permission to actually use your camera. Otherwise, it might show up black. So how do you give an app permission? Well, you can either open the app and usually a pop-up appears and says.
But sometimes if you don't do it the first time,
sometimes
it's tough to get it back.
Yeah, so what you do is open the settings app, find the app you want to give permissions to. I think I have Instagram on here. I do, Instagram.
Yep.
And to see that camera turn, make sure that switch is on. If it's green, it's on. If it's white, it's off.
It's off.
But you want it to be on.
So make sure that if it's one app, it's a good idea to check a different app too. Even if it's just the camera app and you have Instagram, check Instagram. Then if it's still black, then we know it's more than just a single app problem.
So here is another problem we came across which might be causing this issue, and that is to check out your configuration profiles and see if the camera is restricted.
Yeah.
Pretty unlikely that this is gonna be the problem, but.
Unless you're a nerd like me and maybe you installed something accidentally. So configuration profiles are little configuration profiles
that
you can install on your iPhone that have settings pre-configured. So one of those settings, which is like parental restrictions, you could disable the use of the camera.
Yeah, businesses can use it too to prevent their workers
from- in a top secret organization. Sorry to cut you off.
No, it's fine. Settings.
Settings, and then go down to General, and scroll down to Profiles and Device Management. If you don't see this option on your iPhone, you don't have it installed. So I'm just gonna show this real quick. Profiles and Device Management. I have a few installed, but this untitled one is one I just created for the purposes of this demo. And you can see there's one restriction enabled, and that happens to be that camera is not allowed. If you
what
see
a coincidence.
That, if you see that, just tap Remove Profile. You have to enter your passcode. That's so secret.
Yeah.
Remove, and then camera's back. It'll work.
Perfect. So if you didn't have a configuration profile, which you probably didn't, last thing. Software-ish to check is, are you using a third-party camera app? If you are, stop.
Yeah.
Because third-party camera apps are not as good as the built-in camera app.
Yeah.
And they're prone to crashing. We used to use a camera app sometimes and it would just crash every other video.
made things difficult. Then we started to use the stock camera app.
Yeah.
And we were like, wow.
Yeah.
This actually works very well.
Yeah, and you know, you can record in like 4K on the iPhone camera.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if it's a third-party camera app, close and reopen the camera app or the third-party app.
Yep,
delete
that doesn't work.
Delete it and just use the regular camera app.
Yeah.
So the next step, if none of that worked, it could still be a software issue. It's the our next step is the DFU Restore.
A DFU Restore is the deepest type of restore you can do on an iPhone. And we have a video that explains how to do it.
Yep.
It's a little bit different on different iPhones.
Yeah, card above, description section below. If you put your iPhone in DFU mode, restore it, still nothing's working, there's probably a problem with the physical camera.
Yep, and this happens when an iPhone gets dropped or cracked or liquid damaged, which can still happen on the iPhones that are water resistant and not waterproof.
Yeah, I mean, they're water resistant, and that resistance wears down over time.
It can, too, yeah, so. And you know, just a little crack. And,
or if you leave it in the pool overnight for 8 hours, and like, oh, where's my phone?
I dropped it at the bottom of the ocean.
Yeah, well, yeah, probably not gonna get it back after that. So, few options.
James Cameron. It's him, James Cameron. Systems are normal.
You guys hearing the song okay up there? A few options you have. The Apple Store, especially if you have Apple Care Plus. Mm-hmm. We recommend some third-party repair companies. We'll link to those in the description section below. Mm-hmm. Or you could consider getting a new phone. And, I mean, especially if you have an older phone and the camera was important to you, you should really consider upgrading because the newer phones have significantly better cameras.
Every year, they come out with the best camera ever on a smartphone.
Yeah, and the iPhone XS Max is like dual cameras in the back and they can record in 4K. And
it really is amazing how good these cameras have gotten.
Yeah.
There are no more point-and-shoot cameras. I'm sorry, Canon. I got one of
them. No more disposable cameras?
Yeah. Well, those still exist. The disposable cameras.
Yeah,
well, they do. Yeah, they're a terrible idea. Buy a new iPhone. Yeah.
Buy a new iPhone.
UpPhone. Is it great? Did we say UpPhone?
We are now. Oh. To check out the cell phone comparison tool on UpPhone, and what you can actually see on UpPhone too is we break down every phone by the camera quality, so you can check like megapixels, dual rear cameras, what types of speeds they can record in, 1080p, 4K, slow-mo.
Yep.
So check that out, upphone.com.
Yep, it's kind of like a search engine for cell phones. You can sort by the best cameras.
Yep, so that's what to do when your iPhone camera is black. Thank you guys for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed. Leave us a comment down below to let us know what you think. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the notifications bell to get an immediate alert on your iPhone.
When we upload a new video.
That's what I meant to say.
Mr. Cameron, we can't believe it. We're done here.